Hey, this is Sanjay here. As I said in the previous video, I have successfully hackintoshed the NUC 8i5BH. Now, I will just share my NUC's hardware configuration. I went with an Intel Core i5-8259U, which has an Iris Plus 655 graphics. I purchased the NUC as a bare bones kit, so I need to add the RAM and the storage. For RAM, I added 2 16GB of HyperX 2400MHz CL14 memory modules to get a total of 32GB of memory. For storage, I went with 500GB Samsung 970 EVO Plus NVMe SSD, which is one of the fastest SSD on the market. Actually, I purchased the NUC for 25,500 Indian rupees, the memory module for around 5,500 rupees, and the NVMe for 7,800 rupees. As of now, the price has come down for each and every product. If you are interested to buy these products, I have given the links in the description below. I haven't used any modern hardware for a long time. This Hackintosh is very fast and responsive compared to my old machine that had an Ivy Bridge i3 CPU and a 4GB of RAM, which is almost 8 years old. Also, that was my first Hackintosh. If you like to watch that Hackintosh playlist, you can click on the card above, or I will link that in the description below. I haven't installed Windows on this machine ever since I bought it. If you like to dual boot, just use 2 storage media for Windows and the Hackintosh. If not, the EFI will be overwritten by the last installed OS. I have planned to buy a separate storage for installing Windows. I am satisfied with this machine. Video editing on DaVinci Resolve is way better than my previous Hackintosh, except the fan noise while editing. That is not an issue for me, but it is something to note. I used this machine to edit 1080p 30fps videos. During the normal operation, it is quite enough. When the CPU is stressed, the fan ramps up its speed and it's quite noisy. Please note that these results are observed when the BIOS configuration cooling profile is set to cool. Unfortunately, I could not buy the passively cooled enclosures like Akasa for NUC because they are not available in my country. While they are great option for silent operation. It is silent when browsing the internet and watching some random YouTube videos. So I have satisfied with those results. I have also benchmarked the machine using some synthetic benchmarking softwares. In Cinebench R23, it scored multi-core 4280 and single-core 971. In Geekbench, the single-core score is 927 and multi-core 4225. OpenCL score is 6936. In Metal, it scored 6013. The CPU performance is quite good. During the Cinebench load, the CPU throttled. The thermal solution is not adequate. If the thermals are improved, we can get some more performance. To get macOS up and running, I followed Dortana guide. The open core version is 0.6.4 and the BIOS version is 85. To install macOS on your NUC, you need to change the BIOS settings as follows. Under device tab, click on onboarding device. Disable the SD card reader. In legacy device configuration, disable CEC and consumer IR. Then head over to security tab. Under security features, enable allow UEFI third party driver loaded, and then change the Thunderbolt security level to legacy mode. Disable Intel Trusted Platform and VTD. In boot section, go to boot configuration and disable fast boot. Under boot devices, disable network boot. In secure boot tab, disable secure boot. Hit F10 to save the changes and hit Yes to apply the change. Okay, let's talk about what's working and what doesn't. First up, let's discuss about the things that are working. Intel Iris Plus 655 works with proper hardware acceleration. The USB 3.2 ports are usable with proper USB mapping. The Ethernet port works, HDMI works. By the way, I didn't test the audio out of the HDMI because I don't have any compatible device with me. The combo jack, aka the TRRS jack, works, as well as the internal microphone. The audio codec is a Realtek ALC-235 and works fine with layout ID 14. Thunderbolt 3 will work. Note that this information is from my reference repository. More information on that later. Wi-Fi and Bluetooth works by using appropriate text from Open Intel Wireless Organization on GitHub. Okay, let's discuss the stuff that doesn't work. The main thing that doesn't work is micro SD card reader, because we disabled it. Actually, there is no text available to get that working without breaking the sleep. And I am aware of Cinetex Kext, but it is not working as expected. Hardware DRM is broken because Apple uses a custom firmware for its DRM. It can be fixed by using an eGPU or using other browsers other than the Safari. My personal issue is that I could not use the microphone on JBL Go Bluetooth speaker. Don't know about other Bluetooth speaker with microphone. I don't own any Thunderbolt devices to test the Thunderbolt port, but as I said earlier, it seems to work according to one of my reference repositories. I had no issues while updating from Bixer 11.0 to 11.1, but I had some issue with proper tree after updating to 11.1. But it is fixed by using Author's solution, which is provided on this issue in property repository. I will link this solution down in the description below, so you can check that out. Also, I took Mount EFI Automator quick action for mounting EFI partition from Mount EFI GitHub project to keep it easy, and it is not necessary, but I like to use that because it is handy when I need to mount my EFI partition. As of now, everything is fine. No issue with daily usage. Getting Bixer bootable is not possible from Windows at the time of filming this video, because Apple has changed the way of packing their OS installation. So most probably you need to install macOS Catalina to get Bixer. Then just make a bootable USB for future use, or you can just update to Bixer. I have another Hackintosh, so I used that to make a bootable USB. If you are ready to Hackintosh, my suggestion is not to use the Hackintosh for very important work. If so, have multiple copies of your data. A quick disclaimer: you are responsible for your machine and your data. Do your own research before doing any of this. That said, I have given the link for my GitHub repository in the description, and if you need more information, head over to Dotrena's guide and my reference repository, for which I have provided the link on my GitHub repository. Without the help of those repository, I could not have done this Hackintosh with ease. My EFI is with the functionality what I need. If you need to add some more functionality or remove them, just fork it or just use it as a reference for making your own. Most important thing is the BIOS version matter. If you have a newer BIOS, my EFI may or may not work for you. Hope I have covered each and everything about this Hackintosh. If you have any questions, drop a comment. If you guys enjoy the video, hit the like button. If you don't, hit the other. Subscribe for more content like this, and thanks for watching.